autism intervention training. Part 1, discrete trial training, the building blocks of the therapy. The first video in the series will provide you with an overview of one of the basic tools used in intensive behavioral interventions, the discrete trial. The discrete trial is made up of several distinct components. It begins with SD, or the discriminative stimulus. This is the instruction given by the therapist to the child. Next, the therapist either wait for the child to respond or provide some help in the form of the prompt if needed. Finally, once the child has responded, the therapist is given reinforcement reward for correct response or correction for the incorrect response. The discrete trial is made up of the following three components: SD, in the form of an instruction by the therapist to the child, a response from the child or a prompt from the therapist, and finally reinforcement or correction if necessary from the therapist. Let's now examine each of these three components in detail, starting with SD. Though generally SD is oral instructions, but at times it can be non-verbal. In order to be effective, the SD must have some very clear guidelines to be followed. The SD must be clear and consistent. They should be free of extraneous information. And finally, they should be delivered in a voice slightly louder than normal. Now we will demonstrate what a good SD sounds like. Yes.
Way to go! Wonderful! Touch half. Oh, whoa! Oh, that sounds so neat!
What are you doing?
Match.
Whoa! Now we will demonstrate what a poor SD looks and sounds like.
Touch my nose. Whoa! Put one up for me! Where's my nose? That's right! Wow! Find my nose.
We will play a good SD once again. Take note that the therapist speaks clearly and consistently, uses a short, concise instructions without extraneous information, and speaks slightly louder than here she normally would. Now that we have covered the basics of delivering a good SD, we will move on to the next step in discrete trial prompting or waiting for a response. When the first beginning to teach a new skill or a task, the therapist should immediately prompt after giving the SD. Some form of assistance to help ensure that the child responds correctly. This teaches the child how he or she should respond to an SD. Indeed, any time a therapist is not certain that the child is capable of responding correctly to the SD independently, the therapist should prompt immediately. The next step is the gradual removal of the prompt. This occurs once the therapist believes the skill being taught has been learned. And once here she is sure that the product no longer needed, the removal of the prompt takes place. The therapist must be careful to avoid inadvertently giving a delayed prompt. The situation can occur on the therapist thinks she should know the correct response. The therapist gives SD, pauses and waits for the child to respond. He realizes that the child is not going to respond or is responding incorrectly and jumps in with the prompt. The therapist must decide before delivering SD whether or not to print, and if so, to deliver the prompt immediately after the SD. We will now move on to the third and the final component of the discrete trial reinforcement or correction. Once SD has been given to the child, responds in one of two ways. Either the child responds correctly and reinforcement is delivered, or the child responds incorrectly and the corrective procedure is applied. We will begin with the reinforcement, which is sometimes called reward. When providing reinforcement to the child, there are several key points to keep in mind in order to maximize its effectiveness. Reinforcement is what immediately follows the correct response. Reinforcement is given whether the child responds independently or with the help of a prompt. The second principle of reinforcement is that it should be enthusiastically involved. If you were excited and enthusiastic when delivering the reward, the child will enjoy the reinforcement more, and that will lead to a better learning. Lastly, reinforcement should be varied. If it is same for a very long time, it loses its effectiveness. Remember, effective reinforcement is the best achieved if given immediately after the correct response by the child, given an enthusiastically involved manner, and if reward is varied, it should vary as the effectivity increases. There is one eventuality that if we have not yet covered what happens if the therapist delivers an SD and the child gives an incorrect response. There are two general approaches to dealing with the incorrect responses, one in which an informational no and the one which does not. So the traditional approach is to use an informational no. When the child gives an incorrect response, instead of giving a reward, the therapist responds by saying no in a neutral tone of the voice.
Where does Grandma work?
He works in the house.
No. Where does Grandma work? Say, library.
Library.
Boink! Yay!
Meant to be punishing, but it's simply meant to provide a neutral information that the response was incorrect and will not be rewarded.
Where does Grandma work?
He works in the house.
No. Where does Grandma work? Say, library.
Library.
Boink! Yay! Now you get Starburst!
The therapist then goes on to give the same SD again, but on the next trial, the therapist prompts the child to ensure that the child gets the response correct. Another approach is to leave out the informational no. With the prompt, if the child gives an incorrect response, the therapist pauses a moment without giving reinforcement but does not say no. We have now reviewed the three components of the discrete trial: SD itself, the prompt or waiting for a response, and then finally the reinforcement or the correction in case the response is wrong. Now review the video. In this series, we'll explore these and other topics in detail. We hope that you have benefited from this video and that you will continue to learn as you work your way through this series. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.